So we'll study the number system. Number system mainly of the type natural number, whole number, integers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. So firstly we will start from the natural numbers. Natural number generally denoted by letter N. So this is a symbol of the set. So natural number starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to the so. Next part of the number system is that is whole number. Whole number generally denoted by W. This is a symbol of the set. The whole number starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 to the so on. What is the difference between that natural number and whole number? Natural number starting from 1 and whole number starting from 0. There is one number in that whole number which is a 0 other than natural number. So there is some part in the whole number that we will see first. A, that is part of the whole number. That number is the even number. Even number is the number which is divisible by 2. For example, see here, 2 by 2 is the 1, 4 by 2 is the 2, 6 by 2 is the 3, 8 by 2 is the 4. But non-example of this even number is the 3 by 2 is not divisible by 2. Next, 5 by 2 is not divisible by 5 number is not divisible by 2. 7 number is also not divisible by 2. So examples of the even number is that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 plus so on. Next part of the whole number is that is odd number. The number which is not divisible by 2 or the number which is not a even number, that is called as the odd number. That is, which is not divisible by 2. For example, in whole number, those number which is not divisible by 2, that number is called as the odd number. That is 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 plus so on. So this is the second part of the odd number. We will see the third part of the odd number. That is prime number. C part is the prime number. So which number is called as prime number? The number which has no factor other than 1 and itself is called as prime number. Concentrate on this. The number which factor has itself and only one number, that number is called as the prime number. So we will see that other than 1, we'll think from 2. The factor of 2 is the 2 and 1. What about 3? The factor of 3 is 3 and 1. What about 4? The factor of 4 is 1, 2, 4. We'll see the factor of 5. 1 and 5. We'll see the factor of 6. That is 1, 2, 3 and 6. So see here, in this 2, the factor of 2 is the 2 itself and only one number. Hence that number is the prime number. See about the 3. The number 3 is the number which is divisible by 3 and only 1. We'll see about the 4. The factors of 4 is 4 itself and 1. But this one number which is also divisible by 4. Hence that 4 number is not the prime number. 2 number is the prime number. 3 number is the prime number. What about 5? The factors of 5 is the 5 itself and only one number. Hence 5 number is also prime number. What about 6? The factors of the 6 is 1, 2, 3, 6. The factor of 6 is 1 and 6 is okay. But there is 2 numbers which is also factors of that 6. That is 2 and 3. Hence 6 number is also not the prime number. What about 7? The factors of 7 is the 1 and 7. Hence 7 number is also prime number. What about 8? The factors of 8 is 1, 2, 4 and 8. Hence there is other 2 number which is also divisible by 8. Hence 8 number is the not prime number. So we will write the in the form of set. We will see prime number generated by P letters. These numbers is the 2, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 is also not prime number, 11, because factors of the 9 is 1, 3 and 9. So these numbers is the prime number. So we'll see the last, that is composite number. Composite number. The number which has more than one factor other than 1 and the number itself. So for example, see here, 4 number means simple, those number which is not a prime number, that number is said to be a composite number, that is 4 number. The factor of 4 is the 1, 2 and 4. Means what? The number which have factor other than itself and 1. That is 2. 2 is the factor of this 4. Hence 4 is the composite number. 6. 6 is the factor of 6 is the 1, 2, 3 and 6. So there is 2 number which is also divisible by 6. Hence 6 number is also composite number. So remember that note. Number 1 is neither composite number nor prime number. So after that, next part of the number system is integers. Third part. Integers are the number that can be a number that can be positive negative or zero. So we'll see integers is generally denoted by I in the form of set, that is first number is 0, second number is 1, 2, 3, 4 up to the plus infinity. Here negative numbers is the minus 1, here minus 2, minus 3 up to the minus infinity. These numbers is called as the integers. What is the difference between whole number and integers? Whole number are the numbers from starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to the infinity, and integers are the 0, minus 1, minus 2. Means what? Their negative numbers is also included in the integers. But in whole number only 0, 1, 2, 3, these numbers is called as the whole numbers. So this extra number is included in the integers other than in whole numbers. So after that, we will see the fourth number, that is rational numbers. Rational numbers. Any number that can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. Remember that P and Q are positive or negative. So, example, see here, 0 by 1. 0 by 1 is the 0. So, 0 number is also rational number. Next, 1. 1 is also rational number. What? 1 by 1 is equal to 1. Next, 2 by 1, that is 2. 3 by 1, that is also 3. Means what? 0, 1, 2, 3, these are also rational numbers. Next, we will see the numbers of that form under root of 4. Under root of 4 is the 2. So, 2 by 1 is also 2. So, under root 4 is also rational number. Next, we will see the rational numbers under root of 25. Under root of 25 is the 5. 5 by 1 is the 5. So, this is also means under root of 4, under root of 25. These also are the rational numbers. So, next we will see 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is the 0.333. So, this can be written as 0.3. These numbers is called as a recursing number. Recursing number. So instead of that 333, write down 0.3 bar. So next, write down 7 by 6, that is 1.1666. Instead of that, you can write 1.1 here, 1.16 here dash. So this is called as a recurrencing numbers. If that number is repeating, that can be written in the form of dash, and this is called as a recurrencing number. So if number is in the form of recurrencing, that number is called as the rational numbers. So next we'll see the irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. Any number that cannot be expressed in the, remember that cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q. For example, see here, under root of 2. Under root of 2 is the 1.414213. So there is no any number repeating. That is, no number is recurring. That type of number is called as the irrational numbers. So for example, under root 3, under root of 7, under root of 11. You can take this. So also pi, value of the pi is 1.142857. So there is no any recurring number. That number is called as a non-recurring number. So note is that all non-terminating or non-recurring decimal are irrational number. So this is a short introduction about the number system. After that, in next lecture, we will see this is called as the real line. How to form this real line means which numbers is situated in that real line. We know that this is a R and this is the imaginary line. We will see the detailed explanation about this one dimensional, also in study about the two dimension in next lecture. Thank you.